if I want to subtract these two integers, I can use the same rules for adding integers. And the reason why I can do that is because I can change any subtraction problem to an addition problem. Instead of negative 2 minus 3, I can write negative 2 plus a negative 3. So in other words, bump this minus 3 over here to parentheses and insert a plus sign. It will still give you the same answer. You can trade out a negative sign for a plus a negative. Trade out a negative sign for a plus negative. Now you're right back to the addition rules. I have two negative signs and then three negative signs. How many negative signs do I have? I have 5, so negative 5 is the answer. In this case, I have 5 minus a negative 4. Anytime you have minus a negative, you can consider that a double negative. Double negatives can be traded out for just one plus sign. 5 minus a negative 4 is the same thing as 5 plus 4, and that would give me an answer of 9. Wellman, what can I trade a double negative out for? A plus, right. So if I have back-to-back signs like this, a double negative, I can make it negative 3 plus 7. Once I do that, I can do 3 negatives and then 7 positives. Cancel out these 3 negatives with these 3 positives, and what am I left with? 4 is right. 5 minus 8, what can I trade out that minus sign for? Plus a negative, so 5 plus a negative 8. That gives me 5 positives and then 8 negatives. I can cancel 5 positives with 5 negatives. What am I left with? Negative 3. All right. A negative 2 minus a negative 4. Kern C, what can I trade out a double negative for? Plus. Yeah, I can trade it out for a plus. So negative 2 plus 4. I have 4 plus signs here, and then I have 2 negative signs. When I cancel this out and cancel this out, Murray, what am I left with? 2 positives, so the answer is what? It is 2. Negative 7 minus 2. Kearns J, what can I trade out a minus sign for? Not a positive. Murphy, what can I trade out a minus sign for? Not a plus. Clark, what can I trade out a minus sign for? Plus a negative, yes. So we can do negative 7 plus a negative 2. I have 7 negative signs, 2 negative signs. How many negative signs altogether? 9, so it's negative 9. In this problem, it's A minus B, and you're given the value of A and B. Whenever you substitute in a number for a variable, you should put parentheses around that number unless it is the first item in a problem. For example, A is negative 3. It's the first item in the problem, so there's no need to put parentheses around it. But you have a minus sign and then B. B is a negative 2, so put parentheses around the negative 2. What happens to a double negative, Wellman? Nope. What happens to a double negative, Galleon? Yep, turns into a plus, yes. So we end up with negative 3 plus 2. That means I have 3 negatives and 2 positives. Cancel, cancel. What am I left with? Negative 1. multiplying integers. The rules for multiplying integers, especially for the signs, are the following. If I have a positive times a positive, the answer is positive. If it is negative times negative, then the answer is positive. If it is positive times negative, then the answer is negative. Negative times positive, the answer is negative. Notice if the signs are the same, the answer is positive. If the signs are different, the answer is negative. What would the sign of the answer be at the top of the page? It would be negative. And what is the full answer? Negative 6, right. What's the answer to this problem? Yeah.
Negative 20.
Yeah, negative 20 is right. The answer to this problem? Yes.
35.
No.
Oh,
yes.
46.
How much?
36.
No.
42.
42, yes, the answer is 42. When you get to a problem that looks like this, and you have more than two items, here are the rules for the signs. If you have an even number of negative signs, then the answer is positive. If you have an odd number of negative signs, the answer is negative. What is the sign of the answer for this problem? It is negative, because you have three negative signs. Three is an odd number. It's negative. What is the full answer for this? Negative 10 is right. What's the answer for this problem? It's just 10, because we have two negative signs. That's an even number, so it's positive. What's the answer to this problem? Yeah, negative 60. One negative sign in there. The first person to get the answer to this problem and bring it to the table up here will get double, in other words, two marks on the paper. Answer to the problem is negative 96.